everybody, and welcome to the newest and improved version of Triple Play. I am your new host, Ryan Crothers. I just want to give a quick shout out to Evan Hatmaker and Robert Soltero for hosting this show last year. You guys did such a splendid job, and you left huge shoes for me to fill. Excuse me, I'm already off to a bad start. Well, as you guys can see, we are in a new space, a different space. This space makes us feel a little bit more like family. We're a little bit closer together, and I like that. I like new space. I like feeling like I'm with my family, away from my family. But that doesn't change Triple Play. Tonight's contestants that have joined me, Triple Play is the same. We have Patterson Follis, and we have Shane Palma. Boys, how are you guys doing today?
Feeling good. Glad to be here.
Good.
I really wish you explained to us how the show was going to go before we went on air, but you know what? I'm ready for this.
Yeah, well, that's part of Triple Play, is that you never know until you know. Patterson, where are you from?
I hail from Kansas City, Missouri.
Where at in Kansas City, Missouri?
Lee's Summit area.
Lee's Summit area. Gotcha. Shane, how about yourself?
I am from Long Island, New York.
Oh, all the way up there. Oh, Yankee territory,
yes,
huh?
Sir.
Go Mets, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, go Red Sox, actually. Well, we do have limited time today. We will start having longer shows later on, hopefully. So, we're going to start off this segment was, who was on that team? I'll give you guys a team, and you'll have to name off players from that team. And each player that you guys get right is 1 point. I will be adding up the points here. If I mess up, yell at me. I'll tell you that you're wrong and I'm right. And then if you get someone wrong, then your opponent has up to 3 players that they can guess, so they have up to 3 points that they can get. Are you guys ready for the team?
This is one at a time.
It'll go Patterson, you name player, Shane names a player, and then just go back and forth till one of you misses,
Sounds good.
The other one can get up to 3. Okay. All right, are you guys ready for your team? In wake of the NHL season approaching, as you guys know from last year, hockey is back, and I could not be more happy. What's the big game tomorrow? We have the 2018 Stanley Cup champions, Washington Capitals, playing at the 2019 St. Louis Blues. So I thought, why don't we just do the latest Stanley Cup champion roster? I need you guys to name players from the 2019, not too long ago, when their captain, you might name them later, but when their captain hoisted that Stanley Cup trophy. Patterson, can you give me a player?
Vladimir Tarasenko.
That is 1 point.
Jordan Binghamton.
He is on there.
Pat Maroon.
Yes.
Ryan O'Reilly.
Conn Smythe winner. Former Av, by the way. You're welcome, St. Louis.
LeBron James.
Let me look. No, LeBron James unfortunately does not play hockey, actually. That's a crazy, crazy thing there. Shane, you have up to 3 players you can name, so you get up to 3 points.
I'm going to go with Alex Petrangelo.
Oh.
That is El Capitan of the Blues.
I think that's going to be all I have for
you. That's all you got? All right. No, it's cool. I can name the entire roster. It's also right in front of my face. But after that first little segment, these guys clearly don't know their hockey. I'm just going to throw that out there, but that is no shock to anybody. We have Shano is up over Patty. It's 3-2. He didn't really use his advantage that well, but it's all right. He does have the slight advantage. So, great first round, boys. Great is actually a very overestimation. Let's get started with this next segment, though. This one, it's just a bunch of random questions from a couple sports, not just hockey. Don't worry, no more hockey questions, no hockey questions in this segment, at least.
Okay.
There might be some later.
Okay.
Once again, each correct answer is worth a point. I'll go off, I'll ask Patterson, actually, Shane, I'll ask you first.
Then,
if he gets the question wrong, you or the opponent has a chance to steal the point and get the question right. Each answer, you get a point. You guys understand?
Yeah.
I do.
Good. Here we go. The first question of this second round goes to you, Shane.
Okay.
Who did Babe Ruth hit his first career home run against? Little history for you.
Do you have like a timer?
I have it in my head. You got about 5 seconds left.
Okay.
4, 3, 2, 1. Do you have a team name?
I'm going to go with the Red Sox.
The Red Sox, you know, because why not, is incorrect. Patterson, do you have an answer?
The Brooklyn Dodgers.
The Brooklyn Dodgers, also incorrect. A lot of people might get this confused. Babe Ruth is an icon for the New York Yankees. However, his first career home run, you don't have to look too far for it. Because if you look at Shano there, you might find out who that team was. It was the New York Yankees. So he hit his first career home run against. Don't have to fill out that sheet because neither of you guys got that right. So, next question is for you, Patterson. We'll start off with you. Same sport, the MLB. Who holds the MLB record for most consecutive games with a strikeout?
Alex Rodriguez.
Alex Rodriguez is incorrect. I'm sorry. Shane, do you know it?
Is this pitching or hitting? Hitting as in he struck
they
out?
They struck out most consecutive games, and that's an MLB record. So, hitting.
Is it Aaron Judge?
Ding, ding, ding. It is Aaron Judge once again. Don't have to go too far from the Yankees.
I didn't want to answer
not
that.
A good, not is, a good look for the Yankees
this
in this
is
show.
Bias. This is bias, that's for sure.
There's no biases in here. Next question, Shane. It's just we're reversing. Mm-hmm. So first, the question goes first to Shane. Sticking with the MLB, but this is our last baseball question. Shane, what MLB rookie hit 7 home runs in his first 6 games?
Is it Trevor Story?
It is, in fact, a beautiful story to talk about because he played for the Colorado Rockies, and it is Trevor Story. Sorry, Patterson, you did not get a chance to answer that. But you get a chance before Shane does to answer this next one.
Okay.
Switching sports, we are going to the Cricket League over in India. Hopefully you guys have been keeping up with that.
I have.
So that's a joke. We're going to go to the NFL. You know, keep it a little more local here. And the question for you, Patterson, is what NFL team was originally called the New York Titans?
The Tennessee Titans.
That is incorrect. The Tennessee Titans originated from Houston as the Houston Oilers. Shane, do you know this?
That one, Ryan, is going to be the New York Jets.
It will, in fact, be the New York Jets.
Lots of New York questions. That's
lots
weird.
Lots of New York questions.
That happens
that
to be
is
my football team,
crazy
too.
Crazy coincidence. That was not on purpose. However, I am a little bit richer if you want to talk about that. Shane, this one goes to you. Who holds the best rookie passer rating in NFL history?
I mean, after last season, he wasn't a rookie last year.
He was not. I know who you're thinking of. You don't have to look too far to think who he was thinking of.
I'm going to go with Aaron Rodgers.
Aaron
Rodgers probably wrong.
Is incorrect. Yeah. His rookie season, he was behind Brett Favre.
Yeah.
Patterson, do you know this?
Robert Griffin III.
You know, Robert Griffin III is up there, but he is not. He does not hold the record. We're going to throw it back to Shane. We'll give you guys each one more chance. Do you got anyone else?
I mean, just based off of trends that I'm seeing, I'm going to go with Mark Sanchez, because why not?
That's good, because he's sticking with New York, but that's bad because it's wrong.
No.
Patterson, do you have a second guess? You kind of need the points.
Yeah, I do. The issue is I don't really know.
Yeah, that is an issue.
We'll just go with one of the greats, Peyton Manning.
Peyton Manning. Actually, threw the most interceptions in his rookie season. And set a record for that. So if that was the question, I'd give
see,
you the point.
See, that's what I was thinking.
Yeah, you know, it is confused. Best rookie passer rating, most interceptions. You know, you're going to be a little mad at yourself, Patterson.
I probably will be.
But it is actually Dallas Cowboys' current quarterback, Dak Prescott's best passer rating in rookie history. Patterson's roommate, diehard Dak Prescott and Cowboys fan, so I am sure you're not happy, and he's not happy for you getting that wrong. And I asked that question first to Patterson, So now, Shane, you are getting asked this first. Kind of an easy one. I'm gonna be honest. Which team drafted Brett Favre?
Green Bay Packers.
That is incorrect.
I don't know.
Oof. Isn't that crazy? Kind of tricked you there. It's not an easy one.
It's not easy.
Patterson, do you know which team drafted Brett Favre?
See, I did at one point in my life.
But no longer.
Yes,
is what I'm hearing.
Today, I don't think I know. I have a 1 in 31 shot at this point.
You do?
So we'll go with the New York Football Giants.
The New York Football Giants is incorrect. So we'll give you guys each another shot at getting this one correct.
Well, I know he played on this team, but I don't know if it's correct. So I'll go with the Minnesota Vikings.
It is not the Minnesota Vikings. Patterson.
Was he traded pre-draft or post-draft?
He was traded post-draft, but did suit up for this team and threw his first career pass with this team.
You know what? I'm not really sure. The 49ers.
Oh, no. That is incorrect. It is actually the Atlanta Falcons.
Oh,
the Falcons drafted him. And crazy, most people know Brett Favre for his famous one of his first completions where he threw it, it batted up, and he caught it. But his first ever pass was in a Falcons uniform. He threw a pick six, so that's a little backside, so don't have to fill that out again. Patterson, this is an easy one. I can guarantee you did get a nice little luck of the draw here just based off how this is going.
I'm probably going to get it wrong, just to be completely honest.
You're probably not, to be honest with you. You probably are. Who is the only starting quarterback to win a Super Bowl with two different teams?
Joe Montana.
That is incorrect. Shane.
Peyton Manning?
It is Peyton Manning. How about that? He won one with the Colts against the Bears.
I should know.
Of course, 2015. In his last game with my Denver Broncos, he hoisted Lombardi's trophy. Shane gets the point for that one.
I'm surprised he had enough arm strength to even hold it up.
You know, if you go back and watch the AFC Championship game, he dominated. People sleep on that. Anyways, that is that for the second segment. What we're looking at score-wise is 7-2 in favor of Shano.
This is the most dangerous lead in hockey.
It is the most dangerous lead in hockey, apparently, starting right now. Good thing this is not hockey, Shane. This is triple play, you probably should not blow this. And again, limited time today. So what we will do is I will only have one more question, but this question has multiple answers to it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Like I said, Shane, you're up by 5. We're going to let Patty answer first. It's going to go back and forth. He's going to give an answer. You're going to give an answer. You're going to go until we get all of them, or until you both miss twice.
Okay.
Or if you go past the time limit, which I have in my head, I'll give you 10 seconds. I'll just say it out loud. And this last question, again, you're down, you are losing.
I am.
By 5 points.
Yes.
So there is room. You're not out of the race yet. The question is, the last question, what are the 9 professional sports teams that do not end with the letter S? You just give me one, we'll send it over to Shane. I will start the timer in my head right now and out loud. 10.
The Colorado Avalanche.
That is one. Shane. 10. 9.
Geez.
8. 7. 6.
Boston Red Sox.
That is, in fact, and indeed one. Patterson. 10. 9. 8. 7. 6. 5. 4. 3. 2. 1. Do you have an answer?
I don't have an answer.
It is not. Shane.
Chicago White Sox.
The Chicago White Sox, yes.
Getting hosed.
All right, it is back to you, but you do have one of your 2 strikes used up, so 10, 9, 8,
these three major sports?
These are three major sports.
Okay, cool.
Four.
Okay.
Three.
Counting slower is not going to help here.
Two.
Yeah, I don't have an answer.
One. You don't have one. You're not sure.
My brain is rattled right now.
It is rattled. And that is it. That's your second strike.
Darn.
Last round. Shane, do you have any more answers? Any more guesses?
You know, I'm going to take the points that I have.
You're going to take the points. You don't lose any, but you might as well take the 9-3 victory. I, for the sake of the audience and for everyone here, will tell you the remaining teams. There are four total NBA teams, which none of them were named. Two MLB teams, which Shane named both, and three NHL teams, which Patterson named one. The two remaining NHL teams are the Minnesota Wild. And the Tampa Bay Lightning. The four NBA teams are the Miami Heat, the Utah Jazz, which is tricky because it's a Z, but
it sounds like
it's kind of like that. So the Oklahoma City Thunder, and do you have any guesses on the last one?
The Los Angeles Lakers.
That is so wrong. The Orlando Magic actually is the last one. So those are all nine. Final score, Shano from New York, 9. Patterson from Kansas City to 3. Shane, congratulations.
You
are the winner. He's already, look, he's got his first ring of the season.
I think I should come back next week for my second one prize.
I think you should. Maybe we'll talk about it. But that is it for the first episode of Triple Play of the new year. And we will talk to you guys later.